Good morning, children. Pursue your aim with great determination and focus. Yes, and that was the story about the great Palomi. It's all about her determination and never to give up attitude and strong willpower helped her to live a normal life again. I hope you have read the story and you have learned a lesson that everything is possible in life with great determination and a strong willpower. With that, children, I would start with words to know and other activities of the lesson. So let's start. Words to know. A live wire. Electrical wire carrying electrical current. Yes, those electrical wires which carries electrical currents to your house, is that is the live wire. Sustained, undergo or suffer, like an unpleasant experience or an injury. Yes, whenever you have a injury in your leg or whenever you fall, you have an injury, that means you have sustained that injury. Amputation, the action of surgical cutting of a limb. Yes, see, Palomi had to have an amputation of her right hand. So that means her hand was removed. That and they have put a artificial hand for her. Resolutely, determinedly and purposefully. Yes, something which you have determined that you have to do it in any cost. Bungee jumping, a leap from a high place while the angles of the leg are secured by a long rubber band covered by nylon. Yes, so you must have seen people doing bungee jumping from heights. That is what bungee jumping means. Now be mindful. Think of the word that you associate with being calm or at peace. The word can be anything like quiet, serene, love, mother, or any other. Now keep this word to yourself. Say it in your mind whenever you breathe, whenever you breathe in. Concentrate upon this word and each breath. Even if your mind thinks of other things, bring it back to this word so that you can repeat it while staying relaxed. Try this exercise as long as you can. Build upon it every day. Yes, children. So close your eyes and then think about any word that gets you peace. Aapko jo word shanti deta hai, wo us word ke baare mein socho. And keep repeating that word whenever your mind gets distracted. Just get your mind back to that word and keep repeating it. It can be any word which gives you calm, which peace gives you peace. Do this activity, children. It will help you to have a controlled mind. Now, let's see the question and answers. Who became Palomi's biggest strength? Who became, children? Her parents, right? Her parents were her biggest strength. They were always positive and always saying good things to her. Do you feel that people with special need have to be brave all the time? Yes, children. People with special needs have to be brave and determined all the time because it is not easy. Today we can see we have both hands, we have both legs. But just imagine with a person who does not have a right hand or cannot see, cannot talk or cannot walk. So they have to be brave all the time so that they can go out in the world and prove themselves. Have you interacted with people with special need? Did that interaction help you to realize what they have to deal with on a daily basis? Have you interacted, children, with the person who has a special need? Kabhi aapki koi mulaqat ya baatcheet hui hai aise logo se? Nahi hui hai. Agar hui hai, to imagine how difficult it is. I will tell you, somebody who I know, and he is a boy, and he can't speak or hear. However, he is so active. He can drive a car. He can ride a bike. He has a job. He's working in a company, and he is very independent. He does everything by himself. He has learnt that. He has adapted that nature that. Now, because he can't speak and he can't talk, that should not stop him to go out of the world and prove himself. So he is doing everything as I and you can do as a natural people. But then it is all his willpower and determination that is helping him each day. Palomi's mother used to tell her that her hand would grow back after its amputation. Do you think she could have handled this any other way? Do you think any other way the mother could have handled this children? I don't think so, because once your hand is cut, you cannot grow that back. However, she wanted her daughter to be positive. She wanted her daughter to never give up and to be happy. And that is the reason she used to always say that, don't worry, your hand will come back. As we have seen in the places and the story, people can be cruel. How do you think something like that could affect you? Yes, I've told you the story, and you have seen that people who were visiting Palomi sometimes were talking about the accident, her arm, and how she's going to manage her rest of the life. So it was very negative talks that they were doing with Palomi. And we should always remember, children, that we should always talk positively, because that is what will help us to move on in life. Situations come in life, we have a lot of problems in life, but God has given us one life and we have to live it to the fullest. So now whenever you talk to anybody, or if you see people who are challenged or who are going through such sufferings, always be positive to them. Don't say negative words, because with positive words you can help them to gain that confidence back, and you can yourself feel happy when you make others happy. Okay? In the story, you have learnt about Palomi's determination helped her to overcome huge obstacle in her life. Do you think being determined in your task will help you to achieve your goals? Yes, very, very important. Determination. Ek baar jo aapne thaan liya hai, usko pura karke hi rehna hai. And right now, you are at an age where you need all these children. You should be very focused on your studies, very focused about your future. You have to determine yourself that I have to achieve these goals. How are you going to achieve this? You need to make a plan of it, right? And with a strong willpower, just go for it. You will fail once, you will fail twice, but then that should not stop you. Whenever you fail, you learn something and try to improve on it and then go for it again, right? So that determination nature should always be there. How can you practice determination in life? Again, as I said, focus on something, have a strong willpower, whatever you want to achieve, keep that goal and start making points to that. How are you going to achieve it? See how are you going to achieve it, and then you start working towards it. What role does school play in your life in shaping values? Very important, children. School is the place where you learn all your values, from courtesy to helpful nature to determination to willpower, sharing, loving, caring, everything. And that is what we are teaching you, that when you go out in the world, when you grow up, you should understand these values in life, and you should, as a person, you should have these values so that you can have a better and a bright future. Now let's see B. What kind of things you can say to yourself to help to that helps you to pursue towards your aim? How does it feel when you face challenge? Yes. Now this activity, you have to do it yourself. What are the words that you will use to help you to pursue your aims? All positive words. I can do it. A strong willpower. Never to give up an attitude. Everything is easy. Challenge is a part of life, but to overcome it is also a part of life. Always remember that, right? If there is a problem, there is always a solution, and you are the best person to get the solution for it. Okay, write this in your book, children. Now we have again got Tony and Tutu, and this time the monkey is feeling sleepy. You need to finish your homework, the bird says. Now, no, I am sleepy now. I will do it later. Hey, where is your willpower? You have to do your work. Yes, my teacher also said that the more I exercise my willpower, the more determined I am. Yes, a very strong willpower, children, we should have. No matter what is the situation, never give up an attitude. Should be your attitude at this age. Be positive, be firm about whatever you do in life. Now, subject connect. Write the noun, adverbs and verbs from the following sentence. Read the sentence and write what are the verbs, nouns and adjectives. Okay. Determination is something like climbing a mountain. You have to know what you want to achieve, and then all you have to do is to put your foot in front of the other until you reach top. Climbing a mountain takes a lot of strength and hard work. You may be tempted to quit and turn back when you feel tired or discouraged, but determination means pushing forward and not giving up. Determination increases your chance of being successful in any task that you choose. You can practice focus every day using these exercises. Do the most difficult job first. Eliminate distractions from around you. Stay away from time wasters. Keep reminding of your goal periodically. Most important, plan your day in advance. That is what I told you. Focus on your goal and then plan how are you going to achieve it. That is what determination means. Okay? Find out noun, adverbs and verbs in this paragraph, children. Now, value for life. Determinations mean you have a power to make decision and truly to be controlled of your life. Determination is overcoming obstacles in order to achieve your goal. To stay determined and focused, it is important to have a goal. And yes, very important. This means that you have a liberty to choose what you want to do in life and treat the destiny with respect. You may have to take tasks and may make mistakes, but that will grow. Yes, children, as I told you, with mistakes we learn that how are we going to be a better person. Be wise. So describe your future, it is only determination and perseverance that will help you. You also need to have a problem solving skills. Whenever there is a hurdle in the path, you must be able to look at the root of the problem so that you can have a solution of the problem. Now, when you are facing a problem, first you need to recognize what is indeed the problem. Avoid the problem. You can decide not to deal with the problem, not to think about it, ignore it. Call your dad, call your friends or family, ask them for a solution, break it down. You can break down the problem into steps and take each step at a time to make it easier to solve. Mistaken identity. So, if you make a mistake or is there a hiccup, just focus on that and try not to repeat it. There is no spoon. Nobody is going to give you a solution of your problem. You need to find it yourself, children, and that is the way you would grow in life. Lesson learned. Always learn a lesson from your problems. As I said, every problem has a solution and we have to learn from them so that we don't repeat it. Activities. Now, make a poster to showcase the way you help you to stay focused on your goals. Now, as I said, make a goal, make a list how are you going to achieve that goal and make a poster of it. This is all about determination. I hope you understand the value of determination and now you will plan your things systematically and properly so that you can achieve your goals, children. Read the chapter again, read the question answers. I will see you again with one more new story and value for life. Till that time, be safe. Bye-bye.